you get this. Hello. Hello. Saturday night, it is 8:36 p.m. Central Standard Time. I've been outside. I was actually outside listening to a bunch of Linkin Park. I don't know, Chester Bennington has been on my mind today, man. I wasn't even a huge Linkin Park fan, but. One of the hardest things for lost survivors is guilt and feeling a sense of blame. It's probably the worst thing that you can do to a lost survivor is blame them for the choice that their loved one made. It's just really unfortunate that people and loved ones are blamed for that. There are definitely warning signs, and that is isolation, so self-isolating. Like, I didn't realize that self-isolation was such a key part of that, because a lot of people today are isolated because of COVID or whatever reasons are happening. So I think it's, you know, that's something that that was brand new to me, was self-isolation and withdrawing from all their other interests in their life, which I'm sure is struggling. The interesting thing is that sometimes people hide it. sometimes that's a warning sign of, you know, people trying to tie up their loose ends in their lives. What I don't think is helpful is blaming other people for someone else's choice. You know, the interesting thing here is that everyone is so fixated on one side of the family, nobody's thinking about anybody else's trauma. So why don't we stop telling people who gets to talk about something and who doesn't get to talk about something? Because there's a whole world of people that are in the middle that don't have their minds made up about this story, that have made the decision that they don't want to follow one narrative. And so nobody gets to decide who gets to talk about a public story. I'm not trying to harass any family members. I'm not trying to cause harm to any family members. I am not on Andrea's side. I did early on get stuck in believing that it was a one-sided situation. And I made comments early on that I don't hold today because I have more information. So that's sort of where I'm at today. Ugh, this woman is she's very angry. I think she needs to get out of here, because she called me disgusting and she spoke in all caps. People really want you to see them when they speak in all caps. And then once she had the legal information for them, she was using that information that she had obtained. So her insertion into this story, so a couple red flags I just want to say right off the bat about the situation are the following. First of all, I was not involved in getting anyone an attorney. I had no part in calling attorneys. I've never spoken to any attorneys. I'm not an attorney person. Most attorneys don't take cases that they can't win unless they're unscrupulous and they just want money. But most attorneys ethically don't take cases that don't have a shot. And I just know in my own experience, that's just how it works. Most attorneys don't want to waste your time. And if there's some that will literally just take your money, but that's not the norm. Some attorneys aren't online, and they don't do online payments, which is weird. I had an attorney in Seattle that did not accept electronic information, electronic stuff. So I too had to send cashier's checks, which was weird. But most attorneys will do stuff online. Shouldn't aggravate an attorney that people want to help pay for a client, and that happens all the time in cases where people can set up a trust if people like want to help with legal fees. For an easy to do for an attorney, especially in this case, if they're practicing civil law.
Are you okay?
Civil law.
Are you okay?
So that was another red flag that actually raised some concern for me. So she did file on the 14th and then she didn't file. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is that because Brittany lied to people and told them that she filed documents for them when she didn't. That was part of her charge. I just know that she went to prison for it, and I also know that she faked cancer in the predator hunters community not long ago. So there's that. We don't know where that money's going, and that was part of the reason why I got a refund, because I, one, didn't know who was involved. It's just another person that's entering into the story that saw an opportunity, in my opinion, okay? Oh, my husband's getting a snack. Why am I still in the story? People that are only donating to Letitia are allowed to speak on the story. I didn't join this to be a fundraiser. I donated believing a side of the story that I don't now believe is true, but it doesn't mean that I believe that the other side is true either. If you have to donate to someone to be able to speak on something, that's another red flag, right? Why do I have to pay someone to speak about a situation when I have a platform? So why would I just, so then people say, well, you got your refund, so why would you then continue to talk about it? Well, let's see. I've amassed quite a few people now that are following the story on my platform, some of which don't follow the narrative that's coming out from one side, but they also don't agree with Dre, and they're kind of right in the middle with me. So I'm talking to those people that just play nicely. We only block the jerks. We only block the people that are like, you're an evil woman, you're a blank giver, which, by the way, people keep calling me a blank giver, fill in the blank. When someone takes back a gift and they say, you're a blank giver, that's actually racist. Don't say that. It's not PC anymore. It's really, really racist to use that term. So don't use blank giver. You could just say I was not kind or I didn't give from my heart, but every person that donates can decide if they want a refund, and I made that decision. Her name is Andrea McCray, and she was bullied off the internet, which in the very beginning stages of, I was involved in spreading some of that misinformation, which is, again, because I relied on emotionally charged information, and she is not gonna tell any of us anything. And she has a right to not tell us anything. And she didn't tell us anything to begin with, and that's why we're here. So everyone wanted her to tell us what happened. Nobody would let her tell us what happened when no one would allow her to tell us what happened. No, Annie donated. Annie 100% donated. She paid Letitia. Annie 100% donated. The mods will not allow you to have access to Letitia unless you donate, which is another red flag. I said I believed it was murder. Yes, I did. I don't believe that's true now. who planted that idea in my mind? Who told me that it was foul play? Who, you know what's really weird? You know what's super weird? You know what Letitia told me? Letitia actually told me she didn't care if people made money on the story. Isn't that weird? She said that people's jobs are to do this, right? But now it's a problem that people are making money. I don't care what people are making money on as long as they are transparent in what they're doing. When I first tried to donate to Letitia's Cash App, did you know that I was blocked? It wouldn't even allow the Cash App donation to go through, which was a huge red flag to me. Play devil's advocate. Maybe she really is trying to guard his privacy about what happened. Maybe she didn't want to put it out there. She's not the one that put it out there. It was his mom that posted the police report. I'm just trying to play the devil's advocate. Cash Apps don't have tallies or goals, so you have no idea where the money's going. I would always be cautious of donating to people that you don't know online. You are banned. I'm against a lot of the stuff that Dre does. I told you a million times. I don't agree with the way that she parents. I don't agree with the fact that she homeschools. There's a lot of things that she does that I don't agree with. That doesn't make her a murderer. I'm gonna pin this one just because you guys love to bring this one up. You drag the family's record onto social media. Let's pin this. All right, so let's play devil's advocate. And did you know that the only thing that's on Andrea's record are traffic tickets? So they're saying now because she called the cops to ask them if she was being investigated, that she's now guilty of murder. I don't know about you guys, but if swarms of the internet were trying to accuse me of something, you bet your bottom dollar, I might actually call the cops and ask them if they're investigating me. So, you know what happened? I found out that people were reporting me to the cops. And I actually emailed them and I said, listen, I heard that you're getting these false reports and here's what I was given. Does that mean that I'm guilty because I contacted the police and told them that? No. I sound insane in all of my posts, you know. You don't really know you're in a cult unless you're in a cult. What if Dre had a point to not wanting Vaughn's family there? So what would be things that would concern her about his families to tell her side of it? Why would she be concerned about his dad being there? Would his criminal record be a factor? Perhaps, she has said that. What about Letitia? What's in her record that is causing her concern? Well, she's mentioned fraud, right? And not paying people back and having a history of not paying people back, allegedly, right? So that was Dre's side. And then Letitia's admitted to having a charge for that. I think she has a couple, but I don't know. Either way, everyone has a past, and anyone that says the past is in the past, I mean, yes, you do your crime, you do your time, it's in the past. But there's such a thing as called recidivism. And so some people that are criminals repeat their crimes, not saying that everyone does, but you know, maybe she had valid reasons for not wanting them there. Maybe there was valid reasons online. Maybe online mobs made her not want to interact. Who knows? But we have to we should be able to look at both sides. I can't. Why are you like spamming the same comment over and over again? Andrea is a frugal woman. That's all I know about that. Okay, you're gonna get a spam. Can someone report her for spam, please? I got you. You're gone. I found a new way to ban people. I can actually look you up. When you make up the mind of other people, then you're not doing your job. I can have an opinion on things, but it doesn't mean that I know what's happened. I would literally hate to be that person that like goes on somebody else's live and just like says nasty mean things because she's so angry. Could you imagine? You're so evil. Goodbye.
Hello. Hi. It's Katie. I just wanted to jump on here. Whoa, it's really loud. The dogs are barking. Kids are yelling. I just want to be super clear. Like, I'm not here to be about, like, drama or whatever. It's very clear to me that there's a lot of people that have specific agendas and they're pushing an agenda, whether there's any validity surrounding the concerns. It's becoming so clear that this is some sort of like money grab to get people so enticed and outraged that they will continue to donate to the creators that are pushing the narrative. This case is under investigation by police. There is literally no reason why any lawyers need to be involved at this point. You don't need an attorney for a criminal case, period. It's very clear it's to push fundraising. Very clear in my opinion. More money means more money for her channel, more exposure for her. And listen, I understand everyone has a platform and everyone can use the story and do it in whatever direction that they want to do, but I don't want to be a part of anything that is exploitative to anyone. Andrea, I don't want to exploit Bon. I don't want to exploit his family. I don't want to exploit anyone. Fueling an online mob does not help any litigation that would potentially be brought up. A judge would look at this as harassment towards Andrea, and it would look as though they're making their life and situation for Bon unsafe. You went from one side constantly making money. For those of you that are gonna criticize me, I'm not going on 5-hour lives. If I get stars on my already monetized Facebook, that's just Facebook stars. You know, it's 1 cent, I think, for every star. I'm not making a lot of money on this. I'm using my platform to try to send a message. And that message is that this entire story is a farce. And it was built on a lie. And I don't know how else to tell you that. But fueling and pushing a family grieving into a corner to continue to fundraise, to actually pull your channel up, to make people outraged so that you can build your channel, you can get super chats, you can get, you know, all of your membership. It's wrong. But I have never called for anyone. In fact, I call for people to stop. To stop doing these things, to get the hell offline and take care of their families. Where so many people are using this for their own gain. Trust me, I wasn't caring about my platform. I didn't care if I lost 10,000 subscribers. I don't care if I lose 60,000 subscribers because I changed my mind. I don't care if my Facebook grows and I don't care if I make a dime because I'm not gonna go along with a lie so that I can get attention and so that I can like manipulate and take advantage of a family. She controls people and makes people feel like they can't say no or they can't or they'll get blocked. It's a cult mentality, and that's what honestly concerns me, is that unbridled power and her abuse of that power and convincing people to listen to her over everyone else. That hasn't changed. And you can't force someone to get arrested just because you don't want them, because you want them to get arrested. She might have been a shitty wife and a shitty person, and she might have been controlling as all hell, but she probably didn't do that. And of course I've changed my mind. For all of the people that have said over and over and over again that I've changed my mind, of course I've changed my mind. And I didn't change my mind because his family didn't want me to talk to them. But a lot of people are making a lot of money on a lot of lies. And I'm not okay with that. And it's not a vendetta, and it's not to get back at creators. All of them saying that they could potentially get him and take care of them and get custody of him, no, they won't. Every single one of those family members has felonies and has criminal convictions that would prevent them from being able to take care of him. Specifically those that have violent convictions for stalking and battery and, you know, assault. All kinds of rumors have fueled this to a place where it's just so far gone. And a lot of this was started by speculation and rumors generated by one creator named Molly. They came to her house because Dre called the FBI on her and called police on her and reported her to the police. I feel angry because I don't even like Dre, but what's happening to her is so unfair. Everyone jumped onto this bandwagon. I can't believe that any one person is all evil. So if it bothers you that I'm pointing out the deception that's happening online, and I'm continuing to point out the misdirection, the misinformation, and all of the manipulation that's happening to the audience by creators on YouTube, I'm gonna use my platform to, I don't wanna be a part of this. Trust me, there's a lot more things that I could be doing right now. What Molly and Justin are doing and Elle is wrong. This is all drama. That's because this started as a shit show. This was never true from the beginning. Not one second of this has been true. Not one second of this has been honest. I'm the largest creator speaking out, saying that this is wrong, I'm evil, that I'm vile, that I don't care about his family. Fueling an angry mob. For what? Based on a feeling that maybe something isn't right? And you guys are doing and proving Andrea right. If I'm wrong, I will eat my words. Molly is playing with fire, and you are directly trying to interfere in her business. She can sue you for business interference. That's a tort, and it's a civil law that you cannot harm a competitor's business. You don't have to like someone, but if you go out of your way to ruin someone's life because you don't like them, that says more about you than it says about the person that you're mad at. She needs to be stopped. She's so evil. But what you're doing to Bond's family is terrible, Katie. No, if you donated off false pretenses, which I was told falsely why I needed to donate off false information, get a refund. If you feel like you've been defrauded, file a police report. And if it doesn't end up in fraud charges, I will be shocked. I will no longer promote any GoFundMes on my platform. I will no longer promote any Cash Apps. I will not promote anybody. I will not raise money for anyone. Hello. I'm staying out of my comments on these live videos. I'm not even reading them. If you have negative comments, I'm not even caring. I'm not reading them. I have zero narrative to give to you. I just want to show you what's here, and you can decide. There's been a lot of narratives spinning back and forth. Who was drinking from the morning until the night? Come on, you guys. I feel like people want to make this so bad, like the next Amber Heard. Growing up in an environment where there's domestic violence, alcoholism, drug addiction, neglect, fighting, verbal, physical. And I don't think it's one person. I don't, like, everyone is like, oh, she's the aggressor. You put enough alcohol and drugs into anyone, they can become violent, regardless of who it is. Alcohol is known to make people violent. And some narcotics can make people violent if you're mixing with drugs and alcohol. I think this was a toxic relationship, and I think they were both toxic with each other. And I think people want to protect Vaughn. They are two people with completely imperfect lives that are fueled by drug and alcoholism. Drug addiction, alcoholism, and again, poor mental health. a lot for a kid. That when you're in an abusive relationship, you lie to people. You don't tell the truth to cops. You cover for each other. Super common. When cops get involved, for people to cover for one another so that they don't get in trouble. Not tell the whole truth. Protect whoever did whatever they did so that they don't get arrested. Maybe take a breather. That's a cry for help, and that is a suicidal thought. We assume that it's because she's just being a jerk that didn't get help. The kids were relying on adults to keep them safe, keep them out of chaos, educate them. They both pulled them out of school, but they were doing this together. He was on board with a lot of the stuff. This is a toxic relationship. I'm a reporter, and this is what I do. Oh my goodness, you guys are crazy. You guys are really crazy. Oh, you guys are literally crazy. Wow. Come on now, have some common sense. This is a toxic marriage. It's mental health, it's mental illness, it's untreated mental illness, it's untreated drug addiction. It's clearly they both had a lot of pain. Alcoholism. There's a lot of people that deal with abuse of alcohol. Children are the ones that are not supposed to be the ones that are in the middle of that. And that's all I'm saying. There's zero reason to follow me because this is not normal at all. I don't know why that's so hard for people to believe. I don't take selfies while my son is in the hospital. My God, you guys are insane. Adults that had a lot of alcohol and drug abuse problems. And that's not a way for a kid to grow up. You know, if your friends are doing this kind of shit, you should be saying something to them, period. And I hope people understand that this story is about, again, domestic violence, mental illness. When kids grow up in these kinds of environments, there's a higher probability of the patterns repeating themselves in their adulthood. And that's why it's so important that we shield our children from this kind of stuff. That's why it's important that our kids are not growing up in environments like this, so that we can break the cycle. So that our kids aren't growing up in an environment where they find normalized abuse and it's just normal for them to see mom and dad wasted, drunk out of their minds, and hitting each other. That's not healthy for anyone, but it's terrifying if you're a child. And the thing is that these kids are so isolated. They're not in school, they don't go to the doctor, they're so away from the world, they don't have friends, that they don't know that this is chaos. That's what worries me, and that's what should worry you, in my opinion. Lawsuits don't need to be started over this, like, honestly, but I'm not willing to say it's all one person's fault. I'm sorry if that upsets you.
Somebody has sex with her. That's mind-blowing to me. Like, somebody finds her arousing. That's mind-blowing to me. Like, I could never be a mental health professional, because I would be so engaged in trying to understand the human mind, and I know I'll never get there. I know that psychology and the study of the human mind is nothing but a carrot rope. It's all it is. It's a carrot rope.